So, how are you all doing? Get on with it. First, we download the module from Magisk here. Then just drag the file into the emulator. If it's on Android, it means it's already in storage. As for the Eld player, everything is in the pictures folder. Let's check first here. The BusyBoxBinary is still detected by Rootbeer. Then we install this module that was downloaded earlier. Yes, the module tab is in the Magisk application, and the module file location is in pictures, if using Eld player. Restart your smartphone, then switch off the module first. Don't switch it on. Restart. For additional explanation, Magisk actually already has a busy box, just to be sure. We add a module like this. Well then now it's easy, just look for the BusyBox default file by the emulator's default root. The file is located here. Actually, the same partition location as in the previous video. If you're watching, delete it immediately! Okay. Restart again. Again, restarting. Okay, not done yet. Let's check here, first guaranteed to be undetectable. And the last step, important because it's useless if we download the module but don't activate it. So just activate it in Magisk. And this last restart for all functions worked for the tutorial in this video. And if we check out this orange application, even though the BusyBox is turned on in the Magisk module, it's still not detected. Well, that's all. Don't you lose sight.